In the previous videos, we defined functions with parameters and return values. In this video, let us gain insights about the functions and variables, the lifetime and accessibility rules of variables with functions and at the main program. Finally, let us safeguard the program, that is the code, against runtime anomalies. The parameters that are defined in the function header and the variables that are assigned within a function are said to exist in that function's local scope. Similarly, variables that are assigned outside the functions are said to exist in the global scope. Based on these two terminologies, local scope and the global scope, we have two types of variables. One is the local variable, that the variable exists within a local scope, and second is the global variable, the variable that exists in the global scope. Remember, a variable must be one or the other. It cannot be both local and global variable. Let us take up the example to demonstrate the global and local scope as well as global and local variable. We have a function that is defined, increment, which takes the parameter x. And this function has two statements. One is increment statement and second is a return statement. And the statements that belongs to a function, including a function header, is called as a local scope. This is the local scope. And we have a second segment, which is a main program, having three statements. And the variables that are defined, for example, data, is said to be in a global scope. The statements that are found outside the functions need not be one function or a multiple functions. The statements that are found outside the functions are said to be in global scope. This is the global scope with respect to this example. We have only one local scope here, as we have one function definition, one local scope, and we have one global scope. And normally we have only one global scope, and we can have multiple local scopes based on the number of function definition. Let us understand the local and global variable. First, let us take up the parameter x. X is found in the function definition. Any variable, that is any parameter that is found in the function, is said to be in its local scope. That's why that parameter is called as a local variable. X is a local variable. And if you define, let us say you define another value, y is equal to x, then we can say that y is a variable, not a parameter, because it takes the value within the body of the function, which is an assignment statement, and y is a variable which is found within the body of the function and it belongs to the scope of the function, and we call it as a local variable, and scope is confined to this function only. Let us take up this variable data. This is found in the global scope outside the function definitions. And the variables that are assigned outside the function definitions are called as global variables. When these program scopes are created by the runtime, that is global scope and the local scope, when the program execution begins, the global scope is created. When the program execution begins, the global scope is created. And upon termination of the program, upon termination, the global scope is destroyed and all the variables, that means all the global variables, are removed from the memory. What about the local scope? The local scope is created whenever there is a function call. When the function is called at runtime, a local scope pertaining to that function is created and all the variables are assigned in this function exists within the local scope. That means they are the local variable and their accessibility is restricted only within the function. And when the function terminates through a return statement, local scope is destroyed and all the local variables are removed from the memory. Let us take up the example. We have a main program. Data 1 is a global variable and data 2 is a global variable. And we have a data 1 increment is a global variable and data 2 increment is another global variable. We have a 4 global variables and this global scope is created when the program execution is invoked by the Python runtime and all these variables are created by the runtime. And we have a local scope here. We have only one local scope wherein we have a local variable x and this variable x is created when there is a function call. Let us say increment data 1 is a function call. When this function call function is called executed, this x is created and upon termination this x is destroyed. Then again for the second function call, again x is created with the value data 2 and it is destroyed upon termination, that is through the return statement. Remember, there will be only one global scope for a given Python program and we can have number of local scopes based on the definition of multiple functions. Let us understand the variable accessibility rules. The first is, the code in the global scope cannot use any local variable. It means that the local variables are inaccessible at the global scope. Second is, the local scope can access global variables. The local scope can access any of the global variables. And third is, the function's local scope cannot use the local variables of other local scopes because the variable defined or a parameter that is found on the function header is accessible only within the function, not outside. Thus, the variables which are defined in a function are inaccessible in other functions. The fourth one is, a same name for a different variables may be used if they belongs to different scope. For example, we define a variable x in a function as well as in the global scope. It is possible because they are found in the two different scopes. But we cannot have multiple variables x in a single local scope. We can define x in multiple local scopes because x in one function and x in another function. It is possible because the variable x is found in different scope, either different local scopes or local scope as well as the global scope. Let us take up the example for this. In this example, we have a function increment, we have a local variable x, and we have another local variable data. This is also local variable as there is an assignment statement. We have two local variables x and data. This is a global scope, and we have two variables, global variables, that is data and data increment. And you can see that, observe that we have a global variable data having same name as that of local variable data. This is possible as this data defined within the function is accessible only within the function. The value of this data is inaccessible outside the function. That's why the data, this variable is different, takes the different memory, and the variable data again, which is found in the global scope, takes the different memory. Thus the output of this is just a value 6. The data 5 is passed here and then 1 is added and it is returned, and which is assigned, and it is printed, that is 6. Why do we require two different scopes? The reason is for the better maintenance and easy debugging. If we have two different scopes and the variables are modified only through the function interactions, then the function interact with the rest of the code only through the parameters and the return value. This narrows down the list of code lines that may be causing an error or bug. Alternatively, if we have only the global variables and we have a bug because of some variables being set to a bad value, and it is very difficult to track down the line of code or the script that causes the error. Thus, if the bug or error is because of the local variable with a bad value within a function, then we can correct that function easily without disturbing the rest of the code. Let us take up four different examples to demonstrate the scope rules. First one, local variables cannot be used in the global scope. Let us take up the function here, span, with one local variable that is called x with the value 31,337, and this is a global scope. We make a call to a function. This function is a void function, doesn't return any value, it just returns none. And here we print the local variable in the global scope. We don't have any variable defined here with x equal to, let us say, 5. We don't have such statement. We are directly using the local variable in the global scope, which is not possible. This local variable is created when there is a function call span, and upon termination there is a implicit return statement, return none. Upon termination the variable is destroyed, and thus that variable x is not available in the at the global scope, which results in an error, and that error is called name error. Name x is not defined. This egg requires a definition here, x equal to 5. If you write x equal to 5 or some value, then you will not encounter this error. We can have variables at different scopes with same name, that is allowed. Local scopes cannot use variables in other local scopes. Let us define two functions. First function is a span with one local variable, that is x, and within this function we make a call to another function, and then we print the local variable, that is x. Here we have a definition for the second function, and this function has two different local variables. One is ham and second one is eggs. What about the usage of the variable eggs? As I said, we can have a variables with the same name at different scopes. Here I have a variable eggs, and its scope is limited to this function, confined to this function. And we have one more variable egg, and its accessibility or scope is confined to only this function. Thus, this type of program having two variables with same name which are found at different scopes will not cause any error. And what is the result of this program? This program results in value 99, as this spam is called from the global scope and eggs are being initialized, assigned with 99. Then second function is called where eggs are made 0 and this variable is destroyed. Remember, this variable is not accessible here. This is a totally a different variable. And upon termination, we are going to print the eggs. That is a local variable of this function. Thus, 99 is printed because of this function call. Global variables can be read from a local scope. Let us define the function spam, which prints the variable x, which is a global variable. And we create a global variable here, that is with the value 42, and then we make a call, and we can access the global variable in the local scope, which prints 42, and then again in the global scope we are printing the same global variable, that is x, which again prints 42. Thus we get the answer 42, which is a result of print at the local scope, and second print is a print which is found in the global scope. Thus we can access the global variable in any of the local scopes, or we can access the global variable inside the function. That is what the intuition. We can have local and global variables with the same name, as well as we can have the variables in multiple local scope with the same name. In this example, we have two functions. First is a span, and this is another function, and this is the main program, which is a global scope. And we have created three different variables with the same name. Here is a variable x, which is a global variable, and here is another variable x, which is a local variable, belongs to this function, and here again there is a variable which belongs to this second function. What is the output of this function, this program? First, this function is called, program control is transferred to this function, and now x gets the value local, and we print and we get this answer. Then this second function is called, there is a spam is called, again x gets different value and this is printed, spam local, and upon termination we are going to print this again, the value x, and again we get the same value here as that of which is assigned, and finally the execution resumes at the global scope, and we are going to print the variable x here. This x belongs to this global variable, and we are going to print the value global. This is how you can have a same variable at multiple local scopes as well as a global scope with the same name and separate memory that is being allocated for these variables by the Python runtime. As I said earlier, the global variable is accessible within the function. Can I modify the global variable within a function, within the local scope? Yes, it is possible with the use of global statement. Let us take up the example here. We have a function called spam, and we have a global scope here. We have defined a global variable x with the value global, and we make a call to a function. Now we move on to the local scope, and we want to modify the global variable here. I can access the global variable like print x, I can do, but I want to change the value of this global variable. For that, I need to use a global statement. Global statement takes the form global keyword followed by the global variable name. And once we use this global statement, definitely we can modify the global variable. Now I can change the value of x from global to spam. This is how the programmer can modify the value of a global variable at different local scopes or at different functions with the help of global statement. Let us summarize the scope rules. The variable that is defined or used in the global scope is called as a global variable. And you can modify the global variable within a local scope with the use of global statement. If the variable is defined within the function or within the local scope, then it is called as a local variable. And if the variable is not used in the assignment statement, then it is a global variable. Let's take up the example. In this example, we have three functions: function 1, function 2, function 3, and this is the global scope. We have a variable x, this is a global variable, and there is a function call for the first function, and we can modify the global variable with the global statement, and now the global variable takes the value spam. This variable x refers to the global variable, not a local variable. And the variable x that is found here is a local variable, locally available to this function. It's x, this local variable its scope is confined to this function. Similarly, here we find the variable x, and there is no assignment statement within this function. Thus, this x refers to the global variable. Let us take up one more example. If you want to modify the global variable within a local scope, you must use a global statement. If you don't use a global statement, then it may be considered as a local variable provided there is an assignment statement. Otherwise, it results in an error. Let us have a look. Here we have a global scope where we have defined a global variable x, and we are using that global variable here. This is valid. We can use this global variable in the local function, but we cannot modify this global variable. This is not permitted. This is permitted if you use the global statement, global x. If you write global x here, then you are allowed to modify this variable, global variable. That's why if you run this code, you will result in this type of error, unbound local error, local variable x referenced before assignment. In order to safeguard the code against the runtime anomalies, it is better to equip the real-world programs with a mechanism to detect errors, handle them, and to continue to execute the remaining section or the modules of the programs. Let us demonstrate such a scenario of getting an exception. Here we have a function called div. It takes two arguments, first and second, and returns the floating point division. This is the main program where this div function is called with the first parameter 2 and the second argument 0. And then we print the result. If we run this program, we will encounter an exception, that is a runtime error called zero division error, division by zero. This is a runtime anomaly caused due to the division by zero scenario. How to handle this runtime error? We have a mechanism in Python to safeguard the code against such runtime errors. Let us have a look. In Python, the runtime errors are handled with a mechanism or the elements, namely try and except statements. The code that could potentially have an error should be put inside the try clause, and the remedial action for such a runtime anomaly need to be specified inside the except statement. And the program execution moves to start from the except clause if there is an error due to runtime anomaly. Let us take up the example. Let's consider the same example. Let's equip the same division by zero. There's a division function to handle the exception division by zero. Let's safeguard this code with the try clause. Try clause normally should contain the code that could potentially result in an error. We have kept this floating point division statement, which might result in an exception due to the second operand with the value 0. We enclose, we put that statement inside the try clause, and except takes the syntax except and the type of error. This is the type of exception that is defined in the Python library, and we put the remedial action. It can be a continuation of processing, or even you can stop execution by giving a meaningful message for the a user or to the outside the world. This is how we have safeguarded this code against the runtime error called zero division error. And the main program takes the same form. We make a call with the second operator, operand, second argument zero, and now you will not get any runtime error. You will get a meaningful message. We have put the meaningful message as a remedial action for this runtime error. Note that any runtime errors that occur in a function call in a try block will also be caught. Let us demonstrate the same program by safeguarding the function call instead of the safeguarding the code that might cause an error at runtime. Here, instead of writing try clause for the floating point division statement, we have moved that try clause to a function call, and we have also defined the remedial action like previous example, wherein we print the message for the outside world explaining the cause of error or the reason of error. Let us summarize this session. We can define the variables with local or global scope. We cannot define a variable with both the scopes. The accessibility and the modification of variables, either at local and global scope, is governed by the scope rules. We can define the functions to safeguard the code against the runtime anomaly by using the elements of exception handling, that is try clause and except clause. With these basic concepts of functions, definition, parameters, return values, scope rules, and exception, now you are in a position to develop a complex programs involving multiple function definitions with the value communication between the functions and the main program.